Right, so now we will look at this oil system in more detail. Okay, now we have our oil tank here. So I told you that this is on the right hand side of the engine when aft looking forward. So from the tank through the filter, it comes to the anti-leakage valve first. So this anti-leakage valve is installed on the lube unit. The function of the anti-leakage valve is to prevent oil draining back to oil tank from the lube unit when the engine is stopped, right? So that is the function of the anti-leakage valve. So after the anti-leakage valve, it goes to the main pressure pump, right? So you can see there are two rotors here. So basically this is a two-stage pump, right? And from the pump it goes to the filter. So this is your main pressure filter of the system. So you can see here there are two tappings taken from here and fed to this special thing. Now this is a sensor. This is our oil filter differential pressure sensor, right? So, and in case your filter gets clogged, there'll be a signal sent to EEC from this oil filter differential pressure sensor. And one important thing is that this sensor will send the signal only to the EEC. This sensor will send the signal to both your EEC A and EEC B, right? So just keep in mind, your oil filter differential pressure sensor send the signal to both EEC A and B, right? After passing through the filter and that's another thing. So here you can see a bypass valve. So this will operate in case your filter gets completely clogged. So if this gets clogged, it will engine will not get oil. So to prevent that, you have a bypass valve here, which will operate and allow unfiltered oil to flow into the system, right? So after passing through the filter, then it will go through the servo fuel heater, right? So mainly this part will be discussed during the fuel system dialogue. So the function of the servo fuel heater is to basically servo fuel heater, right? It will heat up the fuel using oil flow through it, right? So just keep in mind that your fuel and oil will not mix, but the oil's temperature will be transferred to fuel system, fuel to heat up the fuel, right? So after going through the servo fuel heat, it will go to the surface air cooled oil cooler. So you find this on the left hand and right hand fan case, that is inner part, around 4 o'clock and 8 o'clock areas. You will find surface air cooled oil coolers in the LEAP engine, right? So you will see when you look at these now when you look from the behind, when you look from behind, you will see these surface air cooled oil coolers on the 8 o'clock and 4 o'clock positions on the inner fan or the bypass path. So after passing through the surface air cooled oil coolers, it will go to the main heat exchanger. Again, here the fuel will get heated up and oil will flow here. From main heat exchanger, it goes to the oil pressurizing valve. So what this does is, it will get the oil to the optimum pressure to be spread to the required areas. So after going through the overpressure valve, the oil will be supplied to different areas. So one part will go to the sump A, the other will go to the sump B, another part will go to the sump C, right? And the next part will go to the auxiliary gearbox, another part will go to your transfer gearbox. So oil will get supplied to five places, axle gearbox, transfer gearbox, sump A, sump B and sump C. So basically your axle gearbox and sump A and sump B will get the supply together, and transfer gearbox and sump C gets a supply together, right? So now that you have supplied the oil, you need to scavenge them, right? So if these light blue colored ones are your scavenge lines, so you can see that here we have 5 element pump unit, right? So now if you wonder why you need 5 units to scavenge air, scavenge oil, so that is when the oil goes through the system and it gets sprayed, oil acts as a cooling medium as well. So when it absorbs heat from different parts of the engine, it gets expand and the volume will be more. So to cater that, to cater complete scavenge of that entire volume, you have to use 5 pumps, right? So that's why you have 5 here, right? You can remember we had only 2 pumps of pressurized, but in this case for scavenging the same amount of oil which we had in the system, we have 5 pumps. And before it comes to the scavenge pumps, it comes through certain strainers, right? So basically we have 3-stage strainer and a 2-stage strainer. So this 3-stage strainer will get scavenge oil from sump A, sump B and auxiliary gearbox, while two stage strainer gets supply from sump C and transfer gearbox. So after it comes to this scavenge pumps, scavenge oil will go to tank, right? So it comes to the tank via a unit which is located here, is known as the deaerator. So what it does is it will separate air from the oil, right? So what we need in the tank is oil. Now due to these expansions and heat transfers and all that, we have air in the system as well. So to get rid of that air, you separate air and oil using the deaerator which is located here. So now after the deaerator, you will have basically two supplies. You have one air supply and a oil supply, right? So this oil will drain to the tank through the special sensor called oil debris monitoring sensor. What this sensor does is it will detect any ferrous particles if present in the scavenge oil. So if it detects ferrous particles, it will trigger an warning in the cockpit. It will say chip detected, right? So in this case you can't dispatch the aircraft, you have to do the related maintenance. So if you happen to find the message chip detected, so what you will have to do is you will have to come here and inspect these 3-stage strainers and 2-stage strainers to identify from where these ferrous particles are coming from, right? And the sensor will send the signal to the oil debris monitoring unit, which is also on the right hand side of the fan case. And this oil debris monitoring unit will send the signal only to EEC channel B. So this is a difference. So your oil debris monitoring sensor will only signal EEC B. So if you access MCDU, and if you go to FedEx, and if you try to we'll say now, if you go to the MCDU and if you go to the FedEx system, and if you check your EECA under the specific functions menu, you will not have this oil debris monitoring sensor input, right? So only in here, only in the EECB channel of the FedEx system, you will get this oil debris monitoring sensor signal, right? So then that and there's another part, right? So I told you that we have oil and air coming into the system here, the aerator. From there it gets separated. You have the oil supply going to the tank, and the air, a part of the air will be used to pressurize the same tank, and another part will get vented through the auxiliary gearbox. So on the top of the tank you find this oil level sensor. So your oil level sensor again will signal EECA. So and when we have the discussion on the FedEx systems, you will see that even though these are two separate units, they communicate with each other using this cross data link connection, right? So any information which comes to EECA can be shared with EECB, or information comes to EECB can be shared with EECA as well, right? So now that is our scavenging system, right? And there are two sensors right here which we forgot to discuss. So quickly we'll go through the all the sensors and we'll summarize the stuff. So and here you have your low oil pressure sensor. So your low oil pressure sensor, you can see it's on the auxiliary gearbox, transfer gearbox feed line. This is your low oil pressure sensor, and here you have a oil pressure and temperature sensor, right? So we have our oil differential pressure, filler differential pressure sensor here, oil debris monitoring sensor here, and oil level sensor here. So now in the system we have mainly five sensors. Now if you check this schematic here, you can see that your oil level sensor give signal to EC channel A only, right? Your oil pressure and temperature sensor will signal both EC A and B. Your oil filter differential pressure sensor signals both EC A and B. Oil debris monitoring sensor signals EC B, and your low oil pressure sensor signals EIU. It's not, the signal does not come to the EC A or B, it goes to the EIU, right? And there's another subsystem in the main oil system. So we discussed the oil pressure system, oil scavenge system, and the other one is the oil ventilation system. So your chambers or the bearings will get ventilated via the center vent body, right? And you can see that the line coming to the oil tank, the separated air from after the debris monitoring sensor will also go to the auxiliary gearbox, and it will get vented through the center body. And there's another thing which an important item which is located here. This is your eductor valve, right? So what this does is it will take 10 stage compressor air, and it will take the air and dump it to the center vent body as well. So what this does is, normally during low engine RPMs, the differential pressure across your seals on the sump A will not be, that means the differential pressure across the seals on the sump A is not enough for proper lubrication. So there can be leakages. So to achieve the required differential pressure, the eductor valve achieve the differential pressure at low RPMs, the eductor valve will take 10 stage air, pressurized air, and put it here and send it through this venturi, right? So then the required differential pressure will be created here, allowing the proper lubrication, right? So basically this is your oil system of the CFM LEAP 1A engine.